You might notice after you drink alcohol, you might notice some bloating, some swelling, some facial swelling. For me, it happens every time. Every time I drink alcohol, I bloat up like a balloon. And this is why. For centuries, we've used alcohol to kill bacteria on wounds, on wherever, on cleaning. Alcohol is used. Alcohol is used in antibacterial products. So you can imagine if you're consuming alcohol, you are killing some gut bugs in there, okay? Especially if you're drinking a lot of alcohol. And usually when I drink alcohol, it's when I'm on vacation or I'm celebrating something. And usually it's not just one glass of wine. If you are working on healing your microbiome, I would suggest give it a good stretch of no alcohol. Try to go like 10 to 30 days or longer without alcohol, especially if your goal is fat loss. And I'm not here to judge anyone. Like I love a good drink just like anybody else, but I also recognize, is this aligned with my health goals? Is this going to do damage to my microbiome? The answer is yes most of the time. And I just got back from the Florida Keys. I had 10 days where I was literally throwing bombs at my microbiome, and I am rebounding and healing my microbiome, and I'm deploying things, everything that I'm sharing with you guys today on what I'm doing to now get back to where I was with my microbiome. Now, your microbiome can be damaged very, very easily. It's a very fragile system, and it can also come back and repair itself quickly. It takes about 3 days for your microbiome to do a complete turnaround and start coming back. Now, there are other things that will tear your microbiome apart besides just alcohol, and that is NSAIDs. So ibuprofen, you take an ibuprofen, it's literally like dropping a bomb on your gut. And I hate to say it, but that is what the research is showing. Sometimes, you know, there's no other choice. You've got to take one. But instead of taking two, try to take one, okay? And this is also another example of when you would want to deploy the probiotics and prebiotics. So you don't necessarily need to use probiotics or prebiotics every day as a supplement form, but using them at specific times when you know you need to heal is extremely helpful. Now, there are foods that you can eat that are incredible probiotics, prebiotics. Now, that's going to be extremely important as well. So alcohol and NSAIDs are the real main ways. Now, some people will say artificial sweeteners can harm the gut, but there really haven't been any studies that really show this in great detail. And the ones that have tried really just use a really high amount of the artificial sweetener versus what you would be taking anyway. And some of the studies on like aspartame and Diet Coke actually have shown some benefits to your microbiome. So listen, it's a personal choice at the end of the day. If you feel bloating, if you feel swelling, if you feel like it's holding you back, then maybe cutting back on the artificial sweeteners is a good idea, but you don't necessarily have to. If your gut is not healthy, you can have something called gut dysbiosis. This is when you have an overgrowth of unhealthy gut bugs and you've got an undergrowth or a starving off of the good gut bugs. This can happen if you're feeding your body the wrong foods and you're allowing those bad gut bugs to take over. Now, what can happen is you can feel terrible, groggy, tired all the time, drained, and you're not sure why. You have no idea what's going on. Why is this happening to you? Like, why do you always feel like you need to go for that afternoon coffee? And the gut could be the reason. And so healing your gut could be the difference between actually achieving your goals and staying stalled out. With gut dysbiosis, your goal should be to balance out your gut microbiome and create an environment where the good gut bugs can flourish. Think of it like a garden. You want the good gut bugs to grow and to just be a beautiful array of a garden with all different kinds of flora. And then you want to take care of the weeds. So if you do damage your microbiome and you do something that you know you can tell it's off, you got to give it 3 days and then can start repopulating and going back in the right direction. And fasting is a major tool to help speed this up. You probably think, okay, with fasting, if I'm fasted, how does that actually impact my gut microbiome? Now, here's the thing. If you're constantly eating all of the time, you're never giving your gut a break. It's constantly going through the motions of digesting the food that you're eating. And these gut bugs, they actually have a circadian rhythm of their own. And so we've all heard that it's beneficial for us to eat when the sun is up, right? For our circadian rhythm. after the sun goes down, if you're eating food, you're actually working against your circadian rhythm, which can hold you back in a lot of ways, but partially because it's holding your microbiome back, because your microbiome wants to go to bed. It wants to sleep. It wants to turn off. Now, we are in a society where we are eating constantly, around the clock, nonstop eating. So if you start fasting, simply fasting 12 hours, now all of a sudden you're giving your body that break so that your gut can go through a cleansing process and heal. Now, this is the cool thing. The bad gut bugs, those bugs starve off very early. So if you go without eating for 12 hours, 16 hours, and beyond, those gut bugs, they cannot survive without food for that long. But the good gut bugs actually flourish, and they actually, it produces an atmosphere for them to be able to start multiplying and repopulating. And so this is what we want. We want an environment like this. And so when you fast, and the longer you fast within the day, the better. So for me, I got into fasting with like a one meal a day fast because I could feel my gut healing very quickly. Within 5 days, I started really feeling a dramatic difference. And by eating one meal a day, one main meal, I'm giving my gut this long duration of time of like 23 hours a day to regenerate, heal itself, but also killing off those bad gut bugs. The amount of fasting that you should do for your microbiome, if you want to start the healing and start allowing yourself to start repopulating and killing off those bad gut bugs without killing off the good gut bugs, that's the magic behind the fasting, would be to focus on a 16-8 hour fast to begin, and then to try to get to like an 18 hour fast. Now, if you can do a couple days of 24 hour fasting, that's great. If you can do more than that, that's even more amazing, okay? So your gut is going to respond very, very quickly. Mine does. Mine responds extremely quickly once I get back to fasting with my normal routine of OMAD.